Welcome to this tutorial. Hi, GMX here, and I want to show you today an alternative way to sharpen up your footage. Let's jump right in. Right here, I added a clip with a deer, and you can see this very nice fur. Right here in the first node, I just added a bit of color correction and added a lot. That's for the moment. The next step we want to do is to change the color space. And to do this, we just add another serial node. Before I added a new grade version. And why we want to change to another color space is that we separate the color from the lightness, or in other contexts, from the luminance. So just jump right to Open Effects and choose the color space transform effect. This is what will do for us the work, and just apply this to the second node. Now we can change the output color space to the lab color space, which separates the lightness from the color values. And bam, that looks very strange, doesn't it? Now we are ready to get the next steps working for us. The cool thing about the lab color space is that it includes the CMYK and RGB colors. It was designed to transform between these two color models. So just create a 3-channel combiner node. And in this first node, we got the lightness. Red is now the red-green components, and blue represents the blue-yellow components. But how can it help us to sharpen up our footage? And as I mentioned, the lab color space is typically used when graphics for print have to be converted from RGB to CMYK, as a Scilab gamut includes both the gamuts of the RGB and CMYK color modes. So next step, just add another serial node. And now we want to change back the color space to our timeline color space. And we do it the same way as we do it before. Just add the color space transform effect on the actual last node. We just do it the same way. We added the color space transform effect on the last node. And now don't change the output color space. What we now want to do is to change the input color space to lab, because we're actually working in lab. So, voila! We are back on the road, but what the hell are you doing, Tim? You will ask yourself. Nothing changes, buddies. You're right. The next steps will show you the technique you can use to create your own sharp look. And we do it by just applying an effect to the lightness node. So just go to the Open Effects panel, and now we want to choose the contrast pop effect. And by dragging it directly to the lightness node, we don't affect the colors. And on the right, you can see a bunch of sliders. And as a first step, we change the detail amount. The detail amount just a little bit, maybe until 0.105, and then increase the detail size just a bit to, let's say, 0.505. Further, we change the low threshold to around 0.4, and finally decrease the high threshold to around 0.5 or something like this. Yeah, that's fine. And voila, here we go. Looks cool. But until now, we just got the drink cold. But now we will put some ice cubes in so that we can feel sparkling in a more refreshing way, even just a bit cooler and very smooth. And as you can see, if I compare it to the first version, now we got some, let me zoom a little bit in and drag it so that you can see it better. Yeah. So that looks very good until now. And to increase the softness, to get it a bit smoother, in our contrast pop effects, let's say to increase the softness to 0.3 around. Yeah, that looks good. You can go further in your own taste, but I recommend don't overdo it, as all other changes too generally. That's what I learned and what I recommend you, don't overdo it. And you can blend it too, but not too much, maybe around 0.3, let's say, and voila! In the direct comparison, you can recognize a sharpen up footage. And in the direct comparison, if we look a little bit further and zoom a little bit more in, you can see it looks very nice. And if you don't go too far with the changing of the values, you don't see noise arising or color bending or something like that. It looks very, very clean just before and now. And look in this area, you can recognize a very, very sharp image in the comparison to the first version. But wait, don't taste it. Let's say we want some very fresh and popping drops on our drink, you know, the sparkling cold feeling. And we can do it by just adding another therion note to this lightness note, just to demonstrate the traditional way to sharpen up. And for doing it, just jump right over, let me zoom a little bit out, and just fit it, compare it again, looks good. And now we jump over to the blur panel, and let's say we want to add a traditional sharpen effect. And the way we're going to do it is jump over to the pull down menu and be sure, oh, it's already chosen. Normally you got the blur, but now we need the sharpen. And what we want to do is to change the radius values. And as I mentioned before, don't go too far. Don't overdo it anyway. That's in general what I recommend you. So let's decrease the radius, maybe till 0.47 is the common value I choose. And when I deselect the node, now let's see. Yeah. And, let me zoom a little bit in. Never. But look, yeah. Oh, that's popping. Voila! But at the end, let me tell you a few last words now. No matter which sharpness effects you apply, the contrast pop or the sharpness effect on the blur panel, if you apply it only on the lightness channel in an LAB color space, you will definitely get the better results. I hope you enjoyed my first tutorial. I hope it could help you a bit. Just let me know in the comments. Tell me if you want to see more tutorials like that. And if you like, please leave a like. This was Tim Yemek. Thanks for watching. Have all a great time. Bye.